Welcome students in this session of Physics New Era channel. Today we are going to know about uses of dimensional analysis. One by one we are going to take the three dimensional analysis or uses of dimensional analysis. In that one, the first statement is as follows. Number one, to check the correctness of a given physical equation. Once again, to check the correctness of a given physical equation. Number two, to obtain the conversion factor between two units from different system. Number three, here it is, number three, to establish a relation between different physical quantities. How it is so? One by one with example I would like to explain that one. Let us see on the board. Here, number one, the first use of the dimensional analysis is as follows. To check the correctness of a given physical equation. To check the correctness, correctness of given physical equations. Physical equation. One by one we are going to take several equations, but instead of that one, here it is full stop. So let us take the example number one. How to establish a relation? We know certain kinematical equations, such as a simple kinematical equation, that is V is equal to U plus AT. This is one of that kinematical equation which already we know very well. How it came? Here acceleration is nothing but a change in the velocity, that is V, final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. So here it is, V is equal to U plus AT. This is one of that equation that we are going to utilize, but we want to check whether this equation is correct or not using dimension. How? We need to obtain initially the dimension of velocity, V, final velocity. After all, it is a velocity only. Then U, initial velocity. Initial velocity. And what about A? A is nothing but your acceleration. Now this is the acceleration. Now what about the remaining term, that is T? That is nothing but your time. Now knowing all that factors or fact, we are going to substitute the dimension of that. We know these two are velocities, maybe initial, maybe final, but this is the velocity and we have the acceleration. So how to obtain the acceleration of that one? Initially we already obtained the velocity, that is velocity is equal to displacement, which is represented in terms of length. I'm going to write that here, upon time. And this time can be represented just like the capital T. So we have the dimension regarding this one, that is L upon T in a square bracket. But while shifting, which is a unit which is present in the denominator, when it is shifted to the numerator, it must be assigned by a negative sign. Just like here it is L raised to power 1, T raised to power minus 1. This is your dimension for the velocity. So this is for the U also, because the related dimension is applicable for the initial as well as final velocity. So what about the acceleration? We know that, in short, I'm going to write this acceleration denoted by the symbol A, which is equal to, in short I'm going to write this acceleration, is equal to A is equal to change in the velocity. Change means difference here divided by time. So we know the velocity, change in the velocity, after all it is a velocity. So it is change in the velocity, I'm going to write L1 t raised to power minus 1. For the velocity, I'm going to write that. And what about the time t? It is in a denominator. So what about this one? If it is shifted to the numerator, it becomes L raised to power 1 as it is, t raised to power instead of that one, minus 1. And here it is t raised to power minus 1. But we know very well that in multiplication, power get added. Minus 1, minus 1 become minus 2. So here it is, addition between these two, L1 t raised to power minus 1, minus 1. So here it is, L raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. This is about the acceleration. After getting the time also, we have the time can be represented in terms of dimension as follows. This is your dimension of t. We got now the dimension of v, dimension of a, and dimension of t. So we are going to check whether this equation is right or wrong, or check the correct equation, whether this equation is v is equal to u plus at or not. Let us check one by one. Here I am going to write the dimension of the first, that is v is equal to u plus at. So here v I am going to write L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 1 for the velocity v. And then this is also same, because maybe initial, maybe final velocity is having the same dimension. So L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 1 plus, here it is, acceleration. We know the acceleration already, we have calculated that value, that is L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2. And here it is, in multiplication we have the time t raised to power 1. As for the, we say, rule it is concerned, L1 t raised to power minus 1 is equal to L1 t raised to power minus 1 plus, here similar quantity is a t and a t. We know that in multiplication, if we have the similar things and we have the power, in multiplication powers get added. So in this one, L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2 plus 1, in multiplication similar quantity powers get added. At last I am going to write here L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 1. And here it is, here L raised to power 1, and here it is how much, t raised to power minus 1. And what about the left hand side, L raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 1. See the three equations in addition to this. According to the law of homogeneity, this equation is homogeneous. Even if there is addition, but this equation is a homogeneous. We say that according to law of homogeneity, equation is correct. Equation is correct. And hence, this equation is a correct one. We said this equation is a correct one using dimension to check the correctness of a given physical equation. This is one of that example. I would like to rub this one, and I am going to take another example of that. Now let us take the example number 2. Here it is another simple equation I am going to take, that is F is equal to m into a. We already got the acceleration dimension, that is a is equal to l raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2. And what about the m dimension of m? Dimension of m it is given by here m raised to power 1. And accordingly, for the force, means simply force is having the dimension, that is m raised to power 1 and l raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2. So we need to check whether this equation it is correct or wrong. Here it is f, where we need to substitute f. For the f we have m raised to power 1 l raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2, which is equal to here m, instead of m I am going to write this, that is m raised to power 1 and into, here it is a l raised to power 1 t raised to power minus 2. Here it is in multiplication and all other quantities are dissimilar. So here it is m raised to power 1 l raised to power 1. I am going to write it in a single bracket instead of two brackets, because all these quantities are dissimilar. So here left hand side is equal to right hand side, and equation is a homogeneous, hence equation is correct. Hence equation is correct. Now take another example of this one, that is number 3. Let us take another example. Here v square is equal to u square plus 2a into s. But what exactly is this s, which is new for us? S means displacement. S means displacement. So I am going to write this. A, we know very well the acceleration. U, initial velocity. V, final velocity. So accordingly I am going to substitute. For the V, we have the dimension, that is here it is L raised to power 1 T raised to power minus 1. Obviously it is same for the V as well as U. What about the A? Already we got the dimension for that one. It is given by L raised to power 1 T raised to power minus 2. And what about the displacement? We know that displacement is nothing but your length. So accordingly I am going to write only L raised to power 1. So yes, V, A, again we say displacement it is, and U and V it is known. Then I am going to check whether the equation is correct or wrong. Let us check here. V, L raised to power 1 T raised to power minus 1 raised to power 2, square of that one. So what about this one? Similar, L raised to power 1 T raised to power minus 1 whole square plus, so constant in the equation has no dimension, so 2 it is neglected. What about the A? Once again, constant in the equation has no dimension. Okay, so accordingly I am going to substitute L raised to power 1 T raised to power minus 2, and here it is a displacement, it is denoted by the symbol L. So here it is, I am going to multiply this power throughout. L raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2 is equal to L raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2 plus L raised to power, here it is 1 1, it is get added L raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2. According to law of homogeneity, होमोजेनेटी इक्वेशन इज करेक्ट, इक्वेशन इज करेक्ट, हियर इट इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल बिफोर यू. आई विल कंटिन्यू द सेकेंड हियर. नाउ वी हैव द सेकेंड यूज ऑफ द डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस, दैट इज टू ऑप्टेन कन्वर्शन फैक्टर, टू ऑप्टेन कन्वर्शन फैक्टर, टू ऑप्टेन कन्वर्शन फैक्टर बिटवीन टू यूनिट्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सिस्टम ऑफ यूनिट्स. सो लेट अस चेक दैट वन. हियर आई एम गोइंग टू चेक whether we are going to get the conversion factor between the two units from the two different system, just like the SI and a CGS. Let us check out that, or we are going to take that MKS and CGS. Let us check one example. If I want to get the conversion factor 1 newton is equal to x dyne, or I am going to write the x in equation format so that you are going to make easy. 1 newton is equal to how much dynes? Obtain the value of x question mark. So let us obtain the conversion factor between two units. But before that one, what exactly is the quantity which possesses these two units? Here it is before you. Newton, dyne, MKS, CGS. Just like that, we are going to obtain that. Here, we have the 1 newton. Newton is the unit of force. Newton. Here, always we are going to write the small letter. Newton is a unit of force. Okay. So even if it is named after the person, I am going to write it in a small letter. So Newton is a unit of force. So force is having the dimension which is given by m raised to power 1, l raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. We already got this. Now we are about to commit the gate to get the relation between 1 Newton and time. What exactly is this one? If I am going to consider 1 Newton that is having the same Newton, M1, L1, T raised to power minus 2 in MKS is equal to in dyne M1, L1, even if they belongs to the two different system, their dimensions are same. That is the key point to get the conversion factor between two system of unit, that is MKS and CGS. So how to get that? Very, very simple. But here into X, because this value I need to calculate, because this is in CGS, this is in MKS, X we want to calculate. How to get that? Very simple. Here I am going to divide whole factor. Here it is X. M raised to power 1, L raised to power 1, T raised to power minus 2 in MKS divided by here M raised to power 1, L raised to power 1, T raised to power minus 2 CGS. So I am going to solve here. One step I will make it here. But here the line is somewhat cross. Okay. Now I am going to take this to this side. So X, I am going to write whole equation instead of that one. I am going to write the units now. For the MKS, what is the unit of mass? the unit of mass is kilogram. So directly I'm going to write kilogram raised to power 1. Okay, or just a kilogram. What about the length? Length it is in meter. And what about the time? It is in second raised to power minus 2. What about the, these are the MKS units. MKS units. And what about the CGS units? Gram, centimeter, second raised to power minus 2. These are the CGS units. So accordingly, you know the conversion factor easily, that X is equal to here 1000 gram is nothing but your kilogram, and here it is gram. So continuously I'm going to write, here it is, we say that meter means 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. What about this second? Similar units don't have any conversion factor, so obviously similar factor get cancelled. Actually it is not get cancelled, but similarity, we are going to get the X. Here it is. Here 1000 means 10 raised to power 3 I can write, and 100 means 10 raised to power 2. So total how much it is? 10 raised to power 5. So 1 Newton is equal to X dime. So accordingly 1 Newton is equal to 10 raised to power 5 dime. This is the conversion factor between Newton MKS and dime CGS. Let us take the example number 2 to obtain the conversion factor between the two units from different system. Here I am going to take we say 1 joule. 1 joule is equal to X erg. So we need to get conversion factor between these two. Clearly we have to understand that joule is a unit, that is SI unit, that is standard international unit. And what about this erg? It is a CGS system. So we need to calculate conversion factor between these two. Initially we want to obtain what exactly is the joule and the erg, a unit of which physical quantity, that is important. On the basis of that one, we need to calculate, or we are going to get the dimension first, and then we are going to obtain the conversion factor between these two. How? Let us see. Here I am going to obtain the, here is the unit, that is joule, it is in erg. So E is equal to, here E is equal to either MC square, or I am going to take we say E is equal to, or that potential energy is equal to MGH. So using both equation, I can calculate the value of that is we say energy. M1 L raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2. On the basis of that one also we are going to get the same. That is for the M, we have this M raised to power 1, and the G, that is the L raised to power 1, and T raised to power minus 2 acceleration it is. So into here is H, that is for the H, here it is, that is L raised to power 1. So togetherly I am going to write this, that is M raised to power 1, L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 2. Means for the energy concept, we are going to get this factor which is having the unit joule. So let us check out now. I am going to substitute here for the joule. Here I am going to write, that is M1 L1 T raised to power, sorry, here it is L2 T raised to power minus 2, that is in SI unit, is equal to X into, in bracket, similar one, even if they belongs to the two different system, their dimension is same. So X is equal to the ratio of these two, M1 L2 T raised to power minus 2 here it is SI system, and I am going to write m raised to power 1, l raised to power 2, t raised to power minus 2 in CGS units. I am going to shift this total to this side and going to solve that. Here x is equal to, here need to substitute all the values. Here mass in SI system it is in kilogram, and length it is in meter, so accordingly meter square. What about the second, their time, it is in second, second raised to power minus 2. Similarly in denominator we have the CGS units, so accordingly I am going to write CGS, that is gram. Here centimeter square, and what about this second raised to power minus 2. So we need to obtain firstly the conversion factor. We know that 1 kilogram means, here I am going to substitute that 1000 kilogram means 1 gram. Sorry, here it is 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. So substituted that, here it is, and what about the meter to centimeter, that is 100. So square of that one, 100 means 10 raised to power 2 whole square into meters, sorry, centimeter square. What about this centimeter square into second raised to power minus 2 upon second raised to power minus 2. Similar factor we are going to get cancel. Actually it is not going to cancel, but as per our convenience we are going to obtain only the conversion factor. Here 10 raised to power already 2 raised to power 2, here conversion factor 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, or maybe I am going to write 1 meter is equal to 10 raised to power 2 centimeter. And what about this 10 raised to power 2? I have substituted this 10 raised to power 2. Raised to power 2 means 10 raised to power 4. So here 10 raised to power, here it is 3 into 10 raised to power 4. So we are need to obtain 10 raised to power 7. So x is equal to 10 raised to power 7. So 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to power 7 erg. This is your conversion factor for the joule to erg. Here the third use of dimensional analysis is before you. I am going to write the statement. Here is the statement before you. That is third statement. To establish a relation between physical, means to establish a relation between physical quantities. How to obtain the, or how to establish a relation between physical quantities that we need to obtain now. How? Let us start. Here, to establish a relation between different different physical quantities. To establish a relation between different physical quantities, how we are going to establish a relation, let us see one example. Several examples are given in the book, but we need to take one of that example. Here I am going to take one example related to establish a relation between different physical quantities. This is one of the use of dimensional analysis. Let us see. Here we know that T, if T square is equal to M, relation between M, L, G we need to obtain. What exactly is the relation between these three? Here m raised to power x, l raised to power y, and g raised to power, let us consider z. So let us obtain the relation between these three. how the relation it is obtained between these. How to get this? Very simple it is. Here I am going to explain you the terms which are present inside this one. That is mass, m means mass, l means length, g means acceleration due to gravity. Obviously it is acceleration. So acceleration is having the dimension which is given by m raised to power 0, l raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. Only, or either I am going to write only l raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. A quantity or a unit which is absent is written with the power 0 as per the rule. So we know the length. Plainly, the length is having the dimension which is given by l raised to power 1. What I am going to write, m raised to power 1, l raised to power, m raised to power 0, l raised to power 1, t raised to power 0. I am going to write either also. So let us once again write this one, m 0. The unit which is absent is written with the power 0. L t raised to power 0. What about the mass? Here it is. M raised to power 1, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 0. What about the time? We know the time is having this one. M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1. Here M and L are absent. So let us substitute all that. Here I am going to substitute the dimension of T which is given by. Here I am going to start. M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1 is, we say, some constant I would like to take. This constant it is, this is the dimension for the T. Instead of that one, here initially I am going to take out this constant of proportionality. Instead of that one, we know very well, T is equal to some constant K into m raised to power x, l raised to power y, and g raised to power z. In this manner, we are going to establish a relation using dimension. How? Let us substitute k is nothing but a dimensionless constant. So this is a dimensionless constant. So we know that constant in the equation has no dimension. So accordingly, I'm going to write this. M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1 is equal to. Here, our dimension doesn't have any dimension if it is a constant. So mass M raised to power, we say 1. Instead of that one, M raised to power 1. Our remaining terms are 0 raised to power x. What about this L? Only L. What about the remaining terms? It is y. And what about this g? L raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. Acceleration, see? Discarding m raised to power 0, l raised to power 0, 0 quantity. This is z. Then I am going to write in detail m 0. M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1 is equal to M raised to power here 1, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 0. Why? Because this is absent. The first bracket, second bracket, M raised to power 0, L raised to power Y, or here it is power X, L raised to power 1, T raised to power 0, raised to power y. Second bracket. What about the third bracket? Here it is the third bracket. M absent, L 1, T raised to power minus 2 here, not z. Here it is z. Now, one more step. Here it is. M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1 is equal to M raised to power. Give the power to each. M raised to power x, 0 multiplied by any quantity, 0. T raised to power 0. What about this? M raised to power 0. L raised to power 1. And T raised to power 0. What about this? M raised to power 0. L raised to power Z. And T raised to power minus 2Z. Gone collecting the powers here. Here I am going to write M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1 is equal to collect each and every. Here it is M raised to power X. What about this? Here it is L raised to power Y, neglecting raised to power 0 values. What about this? L raised to power Z. And then what about this? T raised to power minus 2Z. So similar quantity power get added. So here it is M raised to power X, L raised to power Y plus Z, and T raised to power minus 2Z. And here it is M raised to power 0, L raised to power 0, T raised to power 1. As there is an establishment of the relation, compare the powers of M and M. Here, now comparing all these two equations, powers of these, comparing powers. After comparing the powers, obviously X is equal to 0. What about this one? Y plus Z is equal to 0. Or I am going to write Y is equal to minus Z. So what about the power, that is last power, that is minus 2Z is equal to, this is the first one, this is the second one. After substituting the powers, comparing the powers, mass with a mass, length with a length, Y plus Z is equal to 0. Okay, and 2Z is equal to 1. What about Z? Z is equal to minus 1 by 2. Obviously, Z is equal to minus 1 by 2 means Y is equal to 1 by 2. So, sub put in 1. Which is that value? Put in equation number 1. What is that equation? Equation number 1. This equation number 1. After substituting, T is equal to K into M raised to power X. What about the X value? That is 0. Unit which is absent is written with the power 0. What about the L raised to power 1 by 2? And what about the G raised to power minus 1 by 2? That is Z. After substituting, I am going to obtain the value of constant. Practically, K is equal to 2 pi and M raised to power 0 is equal to 1. Then we are going to establish a relation, that is 2 pi into L raised to power 1 by 2 into G raised to power minus 1 by 2 can be rearranged just like this, 2 pi into under root of, because here I am going to write one step more, that is L raised to power 1 by 2 upon G raised to power 1 by 2. But any quantity raised to power 1 by 2 is nothing but under root. So this value I am going to write here. Here T is equal to 2 pi under root of L upon G. This is the final equation that we have established. This is the practically we have obtained, and this is the under root of L upon G. L is the length, G is the acceleration due to gravity. Thank you. Now we have the some sort of limitations. We say that these are the limitations of dimensional analysis. For that one, three limitations before you. How? That we are going to see in short. Using the dimensional analysis, we cannot obtain the constant of proportionality. Proportionality constant cannot be obtained using dimensional analysis. Number two, equation containing trigonometric functions. Equation containing trigonometric functions. Equation containing trigonometric function cannot obtain using dimensional analysis. Analysis. And the third and the last one, the statement before you once again, the constant of proportionality. We already obtained several examples regarding that one, just like we say velocity is equal to here 6 pi eta r into v. This 6 pi cannot be obtained, or another equation that is t is equal to 2 pi under root of l upon g. This value constant of proportionality cannot be obtained using, such as 6 pi, 2 pi cannot be obtained using dimensional analysis. Equation containing trigonometric functions cannot obtain using dimension, such as we say sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, etc. Sine, cos, tan, sec, cosec, cot cannot be obtained using trigonometric, using dimensional analysis. We cannot obtain a dimension or equation or relation containing trigonometric functions such as sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, sec theta, cosec theta, cot theta, etc. Now the last one, using the dimensional analysis, we cannot obtain composite or complicated equations as it cannot give idea about sign conventions. Sign convention such as positive, negative. These are the limitations. Means this composite relation cannot be obtained as it cannot give the idea about the sign conventions in that equation. Thank you.